Hey friend, Brandon here. So maybe you or a friend or family member has gotten their hands on a Galaxy Note 10 or 10 Plus, and you're trying to find out some advanced tips and tricks for the device. Maybe you've gone through 3 different videos and you really haven't learned anything new or interesting. Well, hopefully this video will change that for you. Here are my top 25 tips and tricks hidden in advanced features for iPhone switchers and novice users. And of course, if there's anything that I didn't cover in this video that you think that would be helpful for others, go ahead and leave a comment down below and help out the community. Let's wield the power of the Note 10 because this is Tech Today. A portion of this video is sponsored by privacy.com, a free service to help protect you from credit card fraud when shopping online. Find out more information by clicking the link in the description or go to privacy.com/thisistechtoday and get $5 free on your next purchase using privacy.com if you sign up through that link. If you haven't already, please share, subscribe, hit that bell icon to be notified of when I post a new video. There's more videos coming up for the Note 10 and other tech gadgets. And if you haven't purchased the Note 10 yet or you're planning on purchasing some accessories from Samsung, there's a link down below in the description and a promo code to get 10% off your purchase from Samsung. Hopefully that'll save you some money. Okay, tip number one may be a little bit scary for some of you. It depends on if you're really advanced on Android or not, but I promise it'll be okay. This one is actually my favorite and I do it on every single device that I ever get. So if you swipe down from the top with one finger and you hit the gear icon up here, and you type in animations, you can do reduce animation. So this is one option of doing it. Simply click that and it should make animations go a little bit faster. But I found that it's not quite as good as my preferred method. So I'm gonna turn this off and we'll go back. Now, if you scroll all the way down to the bottom and you click on About Phone, and then click on Software Information and go to Build Number and just tap on it until it says that you have to put in your PIN. This PIN number is the one that you set up when you set up your device. So it's not my personal PIN, it's not anything from Samsung, it's the one that you chose. So I just put in my PIN, so let's go back one, and then one more time. If we scroll all the way down to the bottom, you'll see developer options. Click on that, and then scroll all the way down until you see the option under animation scale. So you'll see 3 options here, and we're gonna change it. We're gonna change Windows animation scale to 0.5, transition, 0.5 and animation scale or duration to 0.5. And then you'll notice that this is way snappier now. To compare it, let's go back to the normal speed. See how it's a little bit slower, maybe smoother, but I like the snappy feel. So we'll go back to 0.5. Much better. It really makes your phone feel really fast. Tip number two is actually 2 tips that have to do with your 2 fingers. So if you swipe down with both fingers, it'll bring down the notification shade all the way to your quick settings. So normally you would have to do it 2 times to get there. And the second part of this tip still has to do with the notification shade. So normally if you swipe down, you get the app screen. Because this phone is so big and tall and you normally have to reach up to pull down on a notification shade, it can be a little bit weird to do that. Like maybe you want to use it with one hand. There's a way to pull down on a notification shade just by swiping down on the home screen instead. So if we hold down on the home screen and go to home screen settings, there's this option right here. It says swipe down for notification panel. Let's check that and then click home. Now when you swipe down from the home screen, it'll take you right to your notification shade. And you can even swipe down 2 times to get to your quick settings. All right, tip number 3, let's swipe down to the notification shade and hit that gear icon for settings. And then we'll go to display. Since we have this really big screen, it's kind of crazy to have really big text, at least in my opinion. So I prefer to change the font size. You can go to font size and style, and then make it smaller, and you can fit a lot more on your screen. Or if it's a little bit harder for you to read, you can turn it up, but we'll move it down. Yeah, it's a little bit too big. And if you happen to have the Note 10 Plus, and unfortunately this is not available on the normal Note, you can go to screen resolution and change it to the full resolution. Normally it defaults to 1080p. So click on it and then hit apply and you'll utilize the full screen resolution. Tip number 4 is really nice if maybe this bright screen or interface is a bit much for you. It's called night mode or dark mode. So if you go to the display area, there's night mode right here. You check it, it's a little bit darker, and I think it looks really sharp. It's a little bit easier on the eyes, at least for me and a lot of other people. And because it's an AMOLED screen, having a darker interface or black pixels on your screen will save battery life. All right, number 5 is really helpful when I'm laying in bed, and you probably shouldn't use your phone too much in bed, but if you just happen to do that, like I happen to, and you want to check something out in landscape mode, you can rotate your phone 90 degrees, and this little icon popped up here in the corner. When it pops up, if I hit it, you can manually rotate it. So it's a quick setting and toggle there, and it'll hold it there. So you're not like having it rotate constantly when you're laying down. And then likewise, if you rotate it back to portrait mode, the icon will show up, you can tap it, and it's back to normal. Now, number 6 is really great, especially because of this big, gorgeous screen. It's great for multitasking. It's split screen. So all you have to do is hit the menu button at the bottom and then tap on the app icon itself. And there's an option for open in split screen view. So it'll pop it up to the top, and then you can choose your other app. So you can swipe between them. So say we choose the settings option. Now you have two different apps that are open, which is really helpful. This is my favorite if maybe you're watching something and you need to take some notes in a notes app, or maybe you need to copy something from an email into a documents app. And then you can readjust the size of it. If you want to close it, you drag it all the way down to the bottom. There you go. Now, number 7 is really neat, and you may be familiar with this kind of style if you use Facebook Messenger. There's those little bubbles that pop up. So you can actually do that with your apps. If you go to your settings and you hit the gear icon and just simply type in Smart Pop, it'll bring up this option that says Smart Pop-up View. Just click on that and then click on it over here. Within this menu, you can choose specific apps that can kind of show up in that little pop-up view. So let me enable like the YouTube app. So we'll go into the YouTube app, and then hit the menu or app overview, and then hit the little icon there, and you'll see an option that says open in pop-up view. Now, it'll show up here as a bit of a preview of the app, but you can hit this little button right here that's closing in on the square, and it'll make it into this little bubble here. And you can move it wherever you want. And then whenever you want to access it, you just simply click on it and it opens it up. You can even change its transparency, which is really neat. Enlarge it if you want to, or simply hit the X to close it. Also, if you're wondering why my Note 10 looks different, I have this really sweet concrete skin from our channel sponsor, Dbrand. It really helps my phone from looking all fingerprinty, and there's a bunch of different options there. So if you'd like to check out Dbrand, there's a link down below in the description. All right, tip number 8 is really great if you have kids or they just want to make a call and you don't really want them to go through your phone. Go to the settings, click the search option and hit pin, and then you'll see this pin windows option. It's all the way at the bottom, so enable it. And then hit this little menu icon at the bottom. And then if you hit the icon of the app that you have, there's an option to pin this app. If you pin it, now you can't get out of it. So this is really great if you just want your kid to play a game. To get out of it, you do have to hit the menu and back arrow at the same time. And then it'll ask you to log in again, which is really great for security. Now, tip number 9 is really great, and it may bleed in a little bit to the next tip, but I'll explain that in a moment. So say you have an app open, and you want to switch to the last app that you're in. If you simply just hit the menu icon twice, it'll go to the last one. So this is a bit of a fast app switcher. So I'm just double tapping it and it's going to the last one, the previous one. Now remember this because it'll come in handy for this next tip. Now go back to the settings and click on the search and type in navigation. And there's a navigation bar or type option. So depending on your preference, or maybe you've used another Android phone, you can actually change the order of these buttons at the bottom. Samsung phones have them flipped compared to stock Android like you'd find on a Pixel phone. So you can choose that option here. There's also this option called gestures. So if you click on that one, you'll notice that the bottom looks different now. There's 3 different lines here, and they act kind of like those 3 buttons that you have normally, and it'll follow the different button order that you have chosen. So I have mine set up kind of like a Pixel phone. So now instead of just simply tapping on them, you just swipe up. Or if you swipe up from the right side, it'll go to your app overview. And now if you remember our last tip, we just swipe up 2 times from the menu overview, which I have now on the right side. If you do that twice, it'll switch to the last app. But this may feel a little bit clunky. So one other gesture that you can use is just swiping right from the middle one, and it'll go to your last app. I think this one's a little bit more intuitive. And of course, to go back, you just swipe up on the left one, if you've chosen that for the back button. Number 11 is really helpful, especially because this phone is really big. You just type in gesture, and then you'll see this option here. It's the second one for one-handed mode. And then you just turn it on. Since we have gestures on right now, there's only one option for us. But if you don't have gestures on, you can choose the button option. But essentially, if you swipe up from the corner, it'll make the screen smaller. So you can kind of reach everything. It's a little bit nice that way. If you need to switch sides, you can do that. It's like your entire phone on this small little screen. And then up top, if you tap there, it'll go back to full screen. Number 12 is really great if maybe you're an influencer or you have multiple social media accounts for some reason. If you go to the settings and type in dual, you'll see a dual messenger option there. Click on it at the bottom. And depending on what apps you have installed on your phone, you can have the option to have two instances or versions of Facebook or Snapchat. And then each one will act like they're separate logins. This is also really great for businesses that happen to handle social media. All right, tip number 13, if you go into the camera app, hello, and you go to Instagram, you can take a picture and it'll go right into your Instagram stories, the posts there. So you can just edit it there and then just publish to your story. By the way, if you're not following me on Instagram, I post a lot of things there. So go follow me at This Is Tech Today. Now you may have noticed that there's only three buttons on your Note 10. There's the volume rocker and this one other button here. It's kind of the on off button, but you can control exactly what happens with it. So if you go to your settings and type in side key, you'll see that option there, tap on it, and you can choose to have it open up BIXBY if you do prefer that as the assistant, or you can choose the power off menu. Also, you can change the double click from the camera to a specific app if you prefer that. I like just keeping the quick launch camera and the power off menu. So that way you can just hold down and turn off your phone. You can also turn off your phone with this button up here. Tip number 15, one of the benefits of the Note 10 is the S Pen. Now, if you go to settings and type in S Pen, there's this option that says S Pen unlock. And then you can enable unlock with the S Pen remote. Punch in the pin that you chose when you activated your device. And then when you take your S Pen and hit the button on it, it'll unlock your phone. So you don't have any pin code or your fingerprint. So just keep that in mind. There's a little bit of a security loss doing that, but there's a lot of convenience. Tip number 16 is the S Pen app shortcut. So whenever you pull out the phone, a list of apps or options come up. If you scroll all the way down to the bottom, there's app shortcuts. So maybe I want to use that for Instagram. Now, whenever I take out my S Pen, you'll see Instagram is one of the options. There it is. Tip number 17 is really great because of Samsung Notes. So let's open up Samsung Notes, take out our S Pen, start a note. Now that I've written this down, you can actually go to this area right here with the T, tap on that, and then it'll convert your writing into text so you can copy it and then paste it somewhere else or simply convert it. Tip number 18 still uses the S Pen. It's for air actions. So go to your settings, type in air actions, make sure it's enabled, and you can change what happens if you hold down the button. So it can open up the camera. That's what I have chosen, but you can change it to other apps. But let's hold it down and it'll open up the camera. Now, if I hold the button and wave up, it changes to the other camera and then vice versa. Back to the back camera. Now, if I want to change the mode that I'm in for the camera, you hold down the button and swipe left or swipe right. You can keep doing that and it'll change between the different settings. And if you hold it down and do a circle left or right, you can determine how far it zooms in or out. So if you do this, it zooms out more, and then vice versa. So now I can zoom in. Now that's really fine if you just want to get really specific with the zoom ins or out. But if you want to just do that quickly, you just hold down the button and instead of doing a full circle like I was doing before, you hold down the button and just stop. See how it's doing that? The opposite direction. So before I was doing a circle, but you can just hold down the button and do like a half circle and hold it. Pretty sweet. And then of course, if you want to take a picture, let's do it this way. You just click. Now this other one is really great if you happen to like GIFs or GIFs, depending on what you prefer. I prefer GIF. Let me know which one you prefer. But if you want to capture a GIF, just take out your S Pen and then choose the one that says Smart Select. There's a GIF option over here and you just drag your screen where you want it and then hit record. And then now I have my own GIF. You can just download it. You can add annotations to it if you want. It's awesome. I love it. And now it's saved to your gallery so you can share it. Tip number 20 is screenshots. If you just click down on the volume button and the power button at the same time, simultaneously, you'll take a screenshot. And then right here, you can adjust the crop. If you have your pen out, you can annotate it and then save it and share it with someone else. Really great. Now, number 21 is glance. If you happen to be in an app and you take out your S Pen, just click on glance, and now it's kind of at the bottom right here. And you can hover your S Pen over it and kind of pop into the app, which is really neat. It's a bit like a picture in picture and split screen if you just need to glance at something real quick. And then you can drag it all the way up to the top to close it. Tip number 22, maybe there's a ton of apps that you have on the phone that you just don't use and it's just kind of cluttering things up. If you hold down on the home screen and go down to home screen settings in the bottom right, go all the way down to the bottom and there's a hide apps option. Now you can just choose which ones you don't want to see anymore. So maybe I don't like using Samsung internet. So I'm just going to click on that and apply. And then now when I go to the apps, I don't see it there anymore. It really helps clean things up a little bit. And if you want to add those back, you just go back and just uncheck it. Tip number 22 is a really great safety feature. If you go to your settings and type in SOS, you can send an SOS message if you're in trouble. So let's enable that. So it states pressing the side key twice is set to open the camera. Pressing the side key 3 times sends SOS messages. Make sure that you only press the side key twice when you want to use the camera. So be very careful about that. So you have to agree to it. And then you have to choose a person that you want to send a message to. So this is based upon your contacts. So I've added one of my friends, but you can add multiple friends if you want. And then what will happen is it'll take pictures using the front and rear camera and attach a 5-second audio recording and then send a message to them. Really, really helpful. Tip number 23, speaking of security, if you go to settings and type in lockdown mode, once again, you have to type in the PIN that you created when you activated the phone, and then the lockdown option is at the bottom. Now, when you hold down the power button, there's a lockdown mode. If we click on it, there's no biometric option. There's no face unlock. There's only the PIN option. Since the Note 10 and 10 Plus have an in-display fingerprint reader, it can sometimes be a little bit finicky. It's new technology. One way you can improve it and make it faster to use is to add your fingerprint multiple times. If you go to the settings and type in fingerprint, there's a biometrics and security option. Click on that. Fingerprint's right here. Enter in the PIN that you created, and then you can add fingerprints. This just gives it more data and allows you to unlock your phone a little bit easier. I personally like adding my fingerprint when it's just normal, and then after I've gotten out of a shower, because your fingerprint looks a little bit different when it's been a little bit wet. Tip number 25, how did I record everything on my screen? So there is a built-in option if you go to your settings and you swipe right. It's under screen recorder, but I find that it's really limited. So I use this app called AZ Screen Recorder. It's absolutely free. You go into it. I'm actually using it right now. And it gives you a ton of options here. You can change the resolution, the frame rate, the bit rate. You can record the audio. You can show the camera if you want to do that. Add text and logo, things like that. It's really, really powerful and really helps me make these videos for you. It's not sponsored, but I get this question every single time I make a tips and tricks video. So before I end the video, I want to give you $5 for watching until the end. Yes, I'm serious, and I'm doing it in partnership with this video sponsor, privacy.com, and their free service that helps protect you against credit card fraud. As someone who has worked in the credit card fraud prevention division at the number one bank in America, buying things online puts your credit card number and personal information at risk, especially with all those data breaches that have become so common now. Privacy.com protects you against fraud in so many ways. You have the ability to create a new virtual burner card for each purchase, which is great for those one-time purchases. You can create a virtual card to make sure those subscription trials stay a trial because you can set a limit on how much they can charge a virtual card. You can even create a dedicated card for your recurring subscriptions and turn any one of your generated cards on and off whenever you want. The best part is that it's absolutely free. They make money from the people you buy things from, not you. And no, they won't sell your data. Protect your identity and your credit card information. Sign up now at privacy.com/thisistechtoday and get $5 if you sign up through that link. Seriously, it is a no-brainer. Sign up now. Do you have any other tips that you think are helpful that I didn't cover? Go ahead and leave a comment down below and make sure you join the This Is Tech Today community Discord chat server. We'd love to have you there. And I would really, really appreciate it if you shared this with others and subscribed and hit that bell icon. There's more videos on the Note 10 and other tech products coming out soon. Thank you for watching This Is Tech Today, where we talk about the intersection of technology in our everyday lives, in business, and in all things creative. Until next time.